This is a revolution.
I am the demo god.
All elite.
Presley squeeze.
Is settled.
I want a match that is
wonderful.
Did John Silver fuck this up?
A paradigm shift.
You wanna kick my friend in his dick?
It's the FTW World Championship.
Bubbly. All right, Kenny's gotta be cool, right?
The All Elite. Best tag team division in the world.
Not the Dippin' Dots. The damn Dippin' Dots didn't do anything to anybody.
Obviously, everybody knows what happened with Mox. He checked in to inpatient rehab for alcohol abuse, and he was replaced by Miro in the tournament. Very interesting choice. Who beat Orange Cassidy? Pretty decent match. But now we're getting Bryan Danielson and Miro in the finals.
I like it. Year.
That's but okay. Where do you see the safe option here with this? Like, who goes over? Because
safe option, I would have to be Miro.
It had to be Miro, yeah. Right? But how would they
safe
do that?
Option? Safe option? Time limit? Make it a triple threat?
Oh, that's no.
Why not, dude?
So that's
why
like
not?
WWE.
Someone's been making the
what do you
joke.
Mean? WWE.
Someone's been making the joke that Brian's gonna win, and then he's gonna come out and make the Kenny Hangman match a triple threat. Like they did at WWE.
No, I know that's what I'm saying. Ongoing, like, it feels like a very similar.
Joke. No, I'm not saying that. Oh. I'm saying make the match go to time draw. Whoever wins out of Kenny and then it gets made into a triple threat for whenever that match.
Yeah, well, it's
happen.
Still the same. Like you're still going to get.
But it's
spot.
A way to save them both. True. It's a way to save them both.
True, because
and implement them in another main event together. So they
because look at it this way, Miro wins. How the hell are you gonna make it? How are you gonna write that he beats Brian? Okay, then he goes on and he loses to Hangman, which would make sense if Hangman.
Ooh,
beats
I know
Kenny.
How he beats Brian.
That's what I'm saying. But if Brian beats Miro, how the hell are you gonna? Hangman beating Brian. I don't know.
That makes Hangman though. Like it
does.
Hangman,
it does.
We all kind of. I don't want to say we agree that it's going to happen, but I mean, it's kind of. It seems that way that Hangman.
I think
gonna
MJ. MJ thinks Kenny's going to win.
Oh, that's true. Well, no, we have to go through.
I hope predictions. Not. I don't know. According to Busted Open, Bully Ray thinks it is not time for Hangman to hold the belt.
Well, let me
he
put
doesn't
this
have
out.
Enough heat. Two years isn't enough.
Let me extend an olive branch. How many times have we seen Kenny Omega in these matches and we all said that he's going to lose? A couple times, haven't we?
Yeah, but not with Hangman. I mean,
no.
Like,
All Out was last one.
No, well, but I'm just saying, guys. I mean, look how many times we've like, oh, Kenny's gonna, he's got to lose this now. He's running stale. Running stale. But he has not lost.
So, what are you leaning towards, MJ?
I'm leaning towards... This is what I'm leaning towards. It's sad I have to say this, but... The more Tony Khan sees people want Hangman and Men, probably he's going to win. But, it's still the other way, too, is that if he sees that they didn't want to win, then he's probably have to make a decision. Do I really want him to win, though? See, it's a double entendre there. It's if he wins, people want it. If he wins, then
they'll be like, no. Well, but like I said, going back to the whole like setting up with Full Gear and having Nero versus Brian. Because like, all right, what if Kenny wins? Kenny retains, and then what? It can't be Kenny versus Miro. Kenny versus Brian.
Out of Brian and Miro, I mean,
Kenny
Brian
and Brian
has
again,
to win.
Though
Brian Kenny's has already... to win.
Yeah, that's true.
He has to win.
If it's
Miro can't win, he can't.
I mean, if Brian does win and he loses to Hangman, I don't know. I feel like it might make people mad, but at the same time, I think it would really make Hangman
it would.
To beat Brian.
definitely more. I mean, it would still, beating Miro would still be something, but like, it's not. Yeah, it's not on the level.
But this
of,
is what I'm saying too, is that Miro is an addition to the storyline now, to what's going on. So that's why true. I think it doesn't matter if he wins or loses, because he's not really supposed to be here anyway.
True.
So it was always supposed to be Brian going over.
And that's, I mean, who knows? Because John, who knows? Because
I feel like that's happened though in the past, where like people weren't even booked in an angle, and then they end up like being the one that has to win or whatever, because that's what makes sense, or that's. Can't give you a good example right now.
I hate to say this. God damn it, I hate to say this, but it's kind of like the situation that Jay White got put in.
Explain how.
Well, Kenny was supposed to lead this New Japan wave, and Kenny said, you know, I'm all elite.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, who's the next best person we can pass this launcher to? Jay White beat the man. Come that's on. True. I mean, that's.
He did.
In New Japan, that's a.
He did. I saw the clip.
No.
Yeah,
shut
it's
up.
Fake.
Shut up.
I saw the clip. It wasn't a three count.
It was a fucking two count.
Yeah, so I guess, I mean, that was pretty much. That was the big thing that happened, the main event. But other than that, I mean, we had a good match between.
I'd say so.
We had Cody and Andrade.
Andrade was pretty good.
Let me finish with this. This whole tournament's been a fuck show.
Why do you say that?
And once
we have an injured guy, a guy that's had to be replaced because he had to go to drug and alcohol stuff. Well, not drug, but alcohol stuff. I mean, that's two big things that's happened in this tournament that wasn't supposed to happen. So,
And then Archer maybe gotten hurt. We don't really know.
He got really hurt because he's still telling people, you know, I'll keep you updated. He doesn't know. He does not know yet. So he said, whatever happens, there's a tweet said, whatever happens in the future happens in the future.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, shit.
Didn't FTR and Lucha Bros be made official?
FTR had a AAA title match.
Yes.
Against Kalisto and Errol Spence.
About that. Yeah. Because there is something that was said.
I know what you're about.
Yeah, it's okay. We can talk about
it. It's interesting to talk about.
Can we just get through Dynamite?
It's interesting to talk about because, so obviously, you know, the former Kalisto had a match on Dynamite.
Samurai Del Sol.
I felt he did pretty good.
Yeah.
So did Aerostar.
It was a fun match. And, you know, FTR retained, of course. But after the match, so there was apparently. Samurai Del Sol announced that he, because this is his first time in AEW, that, you know, he said a prayer and talked to Brody Lee, and it seemed like a heartfelt tweet.
Definitely did.
That he was paying respect to his friend. Well, Jericho retweeted it because in the tweet he put John, but he put J-O-H-N instead of J-O-N, and he said he misspelled his name. And then Amanda Huber, you know, Brody's wife, was also in the comments basically siding with Jericho on it, because Jericho got the shit flamed out of him on Twitter for that. Because, I mean, honestly,
do you think it was like a language thing?
I don't know.
That's exactly what I think.
I don't know if it was just an actual mistake. If they're pissed because he misspelled the name, or if there's like legitimate heat that we don't know about,
right?
Backstage.
Yeah, but why would there be legitimate heat if he's making those types of tweets? You know, for everyone.
I mean, maybe
he's
just trying to suck up to the AEW crowd.
I think people were trying to say. Yeah, I think people were trying to insinuate that Jericho and Amanda might be mad because they think he might be name dropping Brody for clout. When he even misspelled his name. But
wouldn't they say more?
There's been tweets where people have covered up showing that Miro misspelled Brody's name. Like Brody Lee, he misspelled Brody. He put B-R-O-D-Y. Jericho didn't say shit about that.
Oh, really?
Brody.
Like recent ones?
Jericho,
or like within the past year or so?
It was like a back when it happened, yeah. Jericho... even did like some kind of tribute on Twitter like a few years back to Eddie Guerrero, and he spelled it E-D-D-Y.
Hmm.
And
see what I'm saying?
People was like, what the hell?
I mean,
this is my thing. You can't. This is where this culture goes way far out. Said, if I'm sitting here typing after a match and I got a bunch of people around me and I want to make this tweet real quick, I understand you probably won't even have time to make that tweet later because you have to take a shower, fucking get right back to go back to Mexico.
Yeah.
So, I think, personally, this dude's sitting around after the match. He's meeting all these people. He's making this tweet because in his mind, he's like, man, this is what Brody experienced and stuff like that. And he's made the tweet. Didn't even think about the fucking wordage because, dude, he's just making a fucking tweet. Yeah, Twitter's not a real place.
he was friends with... I mean, everybody knows he was friends with Brody. I mean,
he was.
He's okay, that's what I was going to ask, though, because...
He's good friends with all of Brody's other good friends from, like, Tyler Breeze.
Right,
and all
those
them
from, like, FCW, NXT.
Who is part of the Sheets and stuff, because, like, he used to be on there with them. And so, you know, it's not like he wasn't friends with them. But also, it's like, I even tried it on my phone. You know, if I try to just put J-O-N, my phone autocorrects to John.
Bam.
Twitter does not have an edit tweet function.
Hmm.
I mean, how many times have you put out a tweet and then come back later and like, oh,
right,
shit, I misspelled a word.
Yeah.
Edit it, you gotta fucking delete it.
Yeah, you have to delete it all.
And you really think, and how bad of a look would that be if he deleted that tweet after making it?
Well, if he deleted it and then corrected it.
I'm talking about people in the moment, man. We're talking about Twitter, bro.
Like,
people in the moment should be like,
what
the fuck?
It's so weird, because it's like, even if there is something wrong, I think that should have been something that Jericho could have DM'd him himself or
totally
talked
agree.
To him at the
See, this is what I'm saying.
At the show, it was very wrong of him to just to openly do that and pretty much embarrass them.
It seems like AEW signing people without knowing the relationships of these people that are in this locker room.
You think so?
Henceforth, CM Punk, Colt.
Well, no, I think that one, what, you don't think that they told Colt before?
I don't know yet if there's anything. I mean, as far I think as far as that, I think they're both gonna be civil. But I mean, it's pretty clear. You can just see on TV that there's clearly not that. I don't think we'll ever see them like the rumors of them being friendly again. That some people had that. Oh, I guess Colt and Punk squashed the beef. It's like that's clearly
not
true.
No, they could just kind of coexist.
You see that they're keeping away from each other.
And Fish even said on Unrestricted that Adam Cole hasn't attempted to talk to him. They haven't talked to each other. So that's kind of weird.
What?
That they're
bullshit.
Dude.
Come on,
look it up.
He could just be
fucking
messing around.
Yeah, he's working you, man. You don't think
they
hang out or anything?
No, he's not working me, man. I work.
You're good.
Because people think that. Because have you seen where? So everybody knows the next month, Kyle O'Reilly's contract's up with NXT. Apparently, FTR have been having a match with Red Dragon. One of them posted a picture of Red Dragon and said maybe soon.
Ooh.
Yeah. And then some people have also said, like, you know, have been fantasy booking an Undisputed Era like reunion with just those three instead of without Roderick, because, you know, originally before Roderick joined, it was just
yep.
three. So we actually could get the OG Undisputed Era.
Hmm. What about Roddy? Does anyone know what his contract is? Because he hasn't been a name that's been...
Not sure. But another name, guess who else's contract is up next month? Johnny Gargano.
Hmm.
Yeah, but he just came out.
Yeah, like with HBK too, right? Like,
little quick thing. Huh? I like how they call it NXT 2.0, but all of a sudden Johnny comes out during Tommaso.
Right, and that,
it's like, oh, remember me from the original NXT?
Remember this? Yeah,
it doesn't matter if they come out. We see this company release people all the time that are in the middle of a fucking story.
What about Candace, though? Is she, because I know she's pregnant, she's out. No.
Yeah,
she had the baby, didn't she? Or no?
Did she? I don't remember.
I don't think she had it. Did she?
Keep talking about?
Candace and Johnny. Candace is pregnant. She's like super pregnant. Yeah. Like, ready to have a baby, I think, relatively soon.
Candace,
like you know how you're pregnant and then they're super pregnant? She's super pregnant.
Candice LeRae, bro. Johnny Gargano?
Candice LeRae. Johnny Gargano.
What, are you shaking your head? Because
you know who Candice LeRae is.
I don't know who
she had
LeRae
a great
is.
Match.
I know who Johnny Gargano
she
is.
She had a great match in PWG. Okay. She used to be...
Oh, we don't
say
his name.
To, I won't.
What are you talking about here?
She used to be with Redacted on
BT. There's a lot of Redacted.
There's too many Redacted.
There's a lot of Redacted.
All right, so
okay,
fill me in here.
Redacted with the Penis Druids. She used to be with him
as a tag team, an intergender tag team.
As a tag team,
a mixed tag team, if you will. So what? What does that mean? What's your face? Is that you're still not familiar? She had an awesome match.
I know why I don't know her then.
Yeah. She had a great match at PWG. I think it was her and Redacted against the Young Bucks, maybe, and that was one where she was all bloodied up and stuff. That was a fucking
I actually got to see
match.
Candice versus Johnny at a at the PWG show I went to. Bowling Night 3 I always mix it up. 2014 I think it was. I think they opened.
So is this
fucking awesome?
When Candice was with Penis Boy,
they weren't together. They were just tagging.
They weren't together. They were just tagging. Yeah.
I think her and Johnny have been dating for like.
She's been with significant Johnny Gargano for a while.
But yeah. So do we know? Yeah. We don't know Candice's contract status or anything.
But
I mean, Taya.
You know, this
is
good conversation. Now. Yeah, this is a good conversation. It's a good leeway to the next segment. We'll talk about the releases. So. You know, shocker, WWE released more fucking people. And at first, rumors were that it was just going to be office people. And then out of nowhere, they started releasing people, talent. And it was just, it was like a massive release of talent. And it was talent that we didn't expect. Like, there was names on there. I was like, holy shit, no one is
two
safe.
Couples. Isn't that kind of fucking weird? Two couples.
It is kind of weird.
Two couples.
But, I mean.
Well, I know the one. Yeah, you're right.
The one that shocked me the most, Nia Jax. I thought she was bulletproof. I thought she there was no way.
Now, why do you think she was bulletproof, Kyle?
Because she's The Rock's cousin.
Okay. I thought she had the Samoan slip. Sorry. Sorry. I'm sorry.
The what?
Wow.
I'm sorry. The Samoan slip, man. I don't know what
that is. No, but
it's what the Rock had.
So she was released. You know, huge name. Never thought they'd ever get rid of her. I don't want to see her anywhere anyway, but still.
She could have stayed in WWE then.
Yeah, she could have stayed in WWE, buddy. But
all right, so if we were to pick, because I could run down. I have the list right here.
Keith
18
Lee,
people.
Killer Cross, what the? Or Karrion Cross, but he's Killer Cross now. What the fuck? And Keith Lee and Killer Cross both have confirmed that they didn't have any input into what people because people were saying that they like these gimmicks.
Yeah,
it was their idea. They said absolutely fucking not because on Twitter, some guy on Twitter tweeted Cross and said, "Hey, can I have that helmet, bro?" And he said, "Nobody wants that shit, brother."
Oh my god!
how do you get?
And somebody was on Instagram basically talking for Keith Lee about how Bearcat Lee was his idea and it was his idea, and then he actually responded, and he wasn't even like on like a comment where he even
was like
would have been
involved
in.
With, right?
Yeah, yeah. And he responded and said, "No, it wasn't my idea."
I saw a picture.
But,
of...
Yeah, Keith Lee, Mia Yim, Scarlett Bodair.
Do you have the list in front of you? I have it right here.
Hold on.
B-Fab of Hit Row, Ember Moon, Eva Marie, Frankie Monet, Grand Metalik, Harry Smith.
Eva Marie confused
twice.
Me. I'm like, they just brought her back.
Twice. Let's say Dorado.
Imagine being the person who got released from WWE twice.
Tino Sabatelli, man.
Yeah, that's true. Kinda.
Lince Dorado is my new favorite wrestler.
Yeah, for fuck.
Considering what he's been doing.
You know that all of Lucha House Party's gone now?
Yeah.
All of them.
Wow, all of them. You're right.
All of them.
Let's see. Where do we? Grand Metalik, Harry Smith, Jeet Rama, Jesse Kamiya, Karrion Kross, of course, Katrina Cortez. Keith Lee, we already mentioned. Lince Dorado, we mentioned. Mia Yim. Nia Jax. Oni Lorcan. That's another one. Oni Lorcan, I'm disappointed.
Biff.
Throw him up.
Yep.
I'm excited that he's going to be Biff Busick again. I know, MJ, you said you didn't like that name. I kind of enjoy it.
Biff Busick.
Just rolls off the tongue. Biff Busick. Scarlett Bordeaux.
It's like...
Yeah.
Trey Baxter.
Zeta
Ramirez.
Trey Baxter is... I think Trey Baxter is formerly Blake Christian.
Is.
And he's wasted no time. GCW's already booked him on multiple events.
Right. Well, he's got a... pretty sure he only had a 30-day. because he was just in NXT. Yeah. Most of these people have.
Yeah, 30. Yeah. NXT only had 30 days, and Scarlett only has 30 days too, and she's already teasing starting an OnlyFans and talking about how
she just got signed, dude.
Right? And talking about how
she just left. Yeah,
she's talking about how she's got all kinds of magazine opportunities and stuff.
I bet.
And, yeah, I bet.
Jeez.
Yeah, and. But yeah, all that. But dude, I'm telling you, whoever GCW, I'm sure will do it. We need Blake Christian and Alex Zane run back,
yeah,
like, as much as they can do it, because that's that used to be like the ideal match on the indies.
It's true. The one I was confused about was B-Fab of Hit Row, and I'm pretty in tune with like who people are and shit. And I mean, I haven't really watched too much of NXT 2.0.
The fuck is that?
People said that he was really good in Hit Row. I haven't really been watching, so I can't really say.
Apparently they just called him up to the main roster, too.
And Hit Row's the one that was starting that thing with the Bucks. With their shoes.
Oh, right.
Yeah, they were.
But, why bring them up? Like, they're a relatively new stable to begin with, and now you just brought them up to the main roster?
Okay, so that begs the question now I'm going to ask y'all. Why did they get released? Let's think of why could they have gotten released.
Well, okay. So there are rumors going around, but credible journalists have said that that's not entirely true.
But what makes it look credible is that two couples. That's why people are like, it's kind of fucking weird if it's not about. I don't even want to say what it's about because it's so stupid.
Okay, because get this, because you know there's another couple that still exists in WWE. Where one of them got released and the other one's still there. You know, John Morrison's married to Ty Valkyrie,
right?
And she got released. He did.
I mean, maybe she asked because she just wasn't happy. Or
but you got to think they're. I don't know.
I know House Party. I think they had been asking for their release because after it got released, one of them tweeted free,
right?
And had like a heart and like a thankful emoji and stuff.
Right.
But. Yeah, there's been rumors that they got released due to not being vaccinated or refusing to be vaccinated. Like,
so, do you have the specific names?
There's also a rumor.
I mean, Nia, obviously, is the one that we all kind of... She's been rumored.
Oh, God. Oh, we know Nia. She's the one who...
Really?
Who fucking openly tweeted...
Yes. He did not get vaccinated.
I didn't know that. Nia was the one who openly tweeted that, you know, God will protect her.
Yeah. But what about, like... Okay, so if that is true... Then what about Sasha? Because like she's also been very outspoken.
Well, there's also another wrestler right now that has not been on TV. She's injured, but she still says she's not gotten vaccinated. And that is Bayley.
Oh. Wait, she said that she hasn't gotten vaccinated.
Yeah, she's not. I mean, she hasn't said that, but she's pretty much made it clear that she's not.
Interesting. So, if we were to pick, obviously there's going to be a bunch of names that are going to be flirting with AEW or potentially.
Well, I got one more question. If it's not vaccinations, what do you think it could be?
I don't know. Budget cuts is what I was saying.
But did you not hear what they made in the quarter, Kyle?
They're getting paid hand over fist by Saudi Arabia.
Hey, get this. They had just made like hundreds of millions of dollars.
People shoving that in people's faces. Yeah, they made so much money during this quarter. No, they made most of that in one night.
Right.
Sons. Yeah. Some of them are turning it around on people because some of them on Twitter were saying like, if people ask why you released, I'll just tell them that they couldn't afford me because that's what they told me.
That's funny. Holy shit.
Jesus Christ.
The other thing, MJ, to answer your question, I don't know if it's a rumor so much, but I've been seeing it on, you know, all the websites and whatnot about the new edict about hiring WWE female wrestlers and having to be, younger than 25
that's
or some bullshit
so
or whatever.
Because, even though legally they can't do that, they can just say that's what they're looking for, but they can't only hire that because that's against, so many fucking laws.
Or do you think they're going by the mandate rule?
What man? What do you mean?
There's a man, I guess.
With the vaccine? Well, or COVID, you mean?
Like I said, the mandate rule where you have to have this many people working at your establishment that are vaccinated and stuff like that.
Maybe.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because people are like, how come AEW's not enforcing that? Because they're from Florida.
Because most of AEW is vaccinated. As Tony said, a majority of the roster is vaccinated, and they're planning to do international shows soon.
Right.
So
yeah, borders just opened up, I think.
So anyone who wants to go to the international shows have to be vaccinated. Hmm. So
yeah, dude, you know, this is my thing right now with this all. We're so worried about all these venues when we just had 50,000 people in Houston break through guardrails, not getting checked for vaccinations, not getting checked for masks.
Yeah, I guarantee you there's going to be a massive surge.
Wait, so what do you, I don't know.
I literally just canceled. I was supposed to be this weekend. I was supposed to go to Rockville in Jacksonville, but I'm not going because they're doing zero COVID protocols.
Seriously?
The no vaccinations required. They're only encouraging masks, not forcing.
That's Florida, you said?
So like, yep.
Jacksonville?
Yeah, I'm like, not Jacksonville, Daytona Beach. Hmm. Yeah, so which is even
I just
worse.
Went to a show in New York City, and you had to show proof of vaccination just to get in, yeah. Or like a negative test within the past 48 hours.
Yeah. See, that's what I was getting, because you were going to ask me what did I mean by what I said about how that festival had the 50,000 with more people. Was because, how do I say this without being weird? Okay, the mandate's not really, it's not real.
What do you mean? What?
It's not real.
Oh, like people don't follow them.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. It's not real. It's really not, because you only have a select few buildings, people going by it, and then you have people So while they're so worried about all these venues and all these people, oh man, you have to get vaccinated to keep this many workers in here or something. No. It's not going to work out. Texas and Florida is one of those two states that are like, even from the beginning for the mask mandates and all, they're like, dude, no.
I don't know. But yeah, I say let's just go through like maybe like 3 to 5 people from the release.
Yes. Who?
That we would like AEW to pick up.
Yeah. Who do you got, Kyle? We'll go to you first.
Honestly, there's only 5 on that list, and I probably not get something, because I know there's one girl that a lot of people like are kind of high on, that I'm kind of, I was never a huge fan of her, and that's Taya Valkyrie. I'm not a huge fan of Taya, so I don't really care for that one. I'm not saying she's not a good worker, I'm just not a huge fan. But as far as what I saw release that I think would benefit for AEW and I got Keith Lee, obviously. Sure. Ember Moon, I think she's a severely underutilized talent in WWE that could really, you know, should be just pushed to the moon in AEW. I didn't realize that. Werewolf, la. But yeah, but anyway, so Keith Lee, Ember Moon, Scarlett Baudair, Killer Cross, and Mia Yim.
Okay, all very good names.
That's who I think. AEW.
What about you, MJ? Who do you got?
Mostly Keith Lee.
Yeah, right. I know.
Can I just pick one? Can I just pick?
You can
one?
Pick as many or as
I
little
swear to God,
as you want.
If you pick Biff,
no, you can't pick Jay White. He didn't get released from WWE. Although if he were in WWE, I bet he would have been released by now.
I'm not a big Keith Lee guy, so he can just go wherever he wants. Not a big Mia Yim person. She can go wherever she wants. She sucked in Retribution. Get out of my face, Kyle.
Don't judge her by Retribution.
I'm going to judge her by saying yes to doing it. I'm not really a Killer Cross fan either, so...
Wait. So the thing with Killer Cross and Scarlett...
I didn't like him in MLW.
I don't know where the hell... they can go. I would hope AEW want to pick them up, but here's the thing that I didn't think about until it was brought to my attention.
Well, hold on. AEW needs Taya Valkyrie. They need her.
I mean, maybe, yeah. I'm just not a huge fan of her, but I'm
just a huge fan of, please just sign more women so you can have a stable fucking division.
But here's the thing about Killer Cross and Scarlett. They left, you know, the rumors were they left Impact because of Don Callis.
Hmm.
So would they go back to Impact or would they go to AEW Don Callis is?
Now, why would they leave because of... Well, Don was running the show. He's at AEW as
Yeah, now he's just like a talent,
character.
Isn't he, kind of?
There's a difference, right?
Yeah.
Well, he's not at Impact. Well, yeah. I mean, they could go back to Impact.
There's some pretty yeah, bad rumors there with
right.
Don
and
Gallus,
didn't you also hear? I mean, there was also a weird thing with Cross. He didn't want to like, he didn't want to gig. Like, he didn't want to bleed during a match. I don't know if you guys watched it or did. No, there's something like weird. I'll have to send you the link. Something about that. That's why, like, if you watch
AEW,
if you don't
want to
bleed,
bleed
then he better not go to AEW.
Right.
Yeah, that's what I just said. If you want to go to AEW, be prepared. All right,
so MJ, you were just saying names that you wouldn't take into AEW, but who the hell would you?
Who would you
take in?
That's I already said that.
Who?
Ty Valkyrie.
That's it. Just one. Just Taya Valkyrie. That's it.
That's it.
All right, you guys might give me some shit over this.
I swear to God, if you say...
I was thinking about it.
If you say Nia Jax,
well, who is she related to, bro? You want to try to get fucking The Rock over here and get him on AEW TV?
Dude, The Rock is a WWE
lifer. So what? No, not if you start bringing in his family. AEW has, if they just welcome her in with open arms.
So you're saying AEW needs to do a Fast and the Furious?
Yes. Bring in Vin Diesel. No, him and Vin Diesel don't get along.
Yeah, yeah. Well, did you see that recently? Vin Diesel made a post on Instagram basically begging Dwayne or The Rock to come to Fast and Furious 10. And he put in the post, he opened up with to my little brother.
Oh my God.
All right, listen. All right. So, who are you legitimately picking?
Nia Jax. I'm not joking. Bullshit. Okay, I'm not joking.
That's bullshit. That's
bullshit. But if I were, I'll give you three other names. Harry Smith. I feel like he's just a fucking awesome wrestler, technical wrestler. I would like to see him in AEW.
Harry Smith.
Don't you mean Davey Boy Smith?
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. Reading the list. The list is... Sorry. Yeah. I don't want Harry Smith. He's... Yeah. That would be difficult.
Yeah. Did he even do anything? Like, did he even have a
I think maybe
match
in NXT UK, like, a few matches.
At least he didn't do a bunch of Percocet and have a match.
That's true.
Not to go on a tangent real quick, but just real quick, did y'all see that dark match that got that apparently got filmed and it's going to be shown soon?
Which one?
In WWE? Mm-hmm. Cesaro and Walter.
Oh, I did hear about that. Yes.
Yeah, that sounds like a fucking good match.
And
I kind of just wanted to watch that.
Oney Lorcan, by the way, to round out my list.
Oney Lorcan.
Biff Busick is
you
fucking
mean Biff?
Great. Yeah, man, he's so good. Him, fucking him.
How do you beat Biff Busick?
What'd you say?
How do you beat Biff Busick and then go into WWE? Yeah, your name's Oney Lorcan.
Yeah.
Isn't he the one who would go on Twitter and like? Tweeting all caps.
Yeah, all caps. He was also like sleeping under a bench. Like he would I'll have to find the tweets. They're fucking hysterical. But like he was saying that he was like training for WrestleMania. It was right around WrestleMania when he wasn't doing shit. And he was like saying that he was like training and sleeping under a bench. Then he actually like shot promos where he was getting up out from under a bench, and it's ridiculous. He's actually a very funny dude. Like I wish he was able to show that personality a little bit.
Yeah.
Not that I haven't met him personally. Okay. I'm just saying like on TV, like he comes or on Twitter. He comes across as a fucking hysterical dude, but
yeah. All right, so
yes,
prediction. Yeah, so you know that's a good list. So before we get into predictions, real quick, you know, just want to say
done with Dynamite. We want to talk. I want to talk about CM Punk.
We
got to
keep this show moving, man.
You mean Rampage? Rampage.
Well, he was on Dynamite too.
CM Punk and Eddie.
Oh yeah, okay.
But real quick, so CM Punk Eddie had a great face to face on Rampage. It almost
got awkward sometimes.
It almost felt fucking real. Like, I had to, like, is there, like, legitimate heat here or something? Like, what the hell?
What makes you think that, though? I mean, I know the promo, like, cut deep a little bit, but, like...
Yeah, it cut deep, yeah, which it mostly does with Eddie promos anyway. He likes to blur the line between reality and...
It's true.
Everything, but yeah. Yeah, it's a great promo. If you haven't seen it, check it out. But real quick, before we get into Full Gear predictions, just want to say, you know... we wish John Moxley the best in his recovery.
Definitely. Oh.
Let's see here.
Oh, I thought you were going
to... I'm about to say, I was like, what are you going to say after that?
I thought y'all were going to say...
No, I thought... No,
you said before we get started in his recovery.
No, I...
Okay.
Yes.
That's what you just did.
I think we all share the same sentiment. Yeah, we definitely...
Yeah.
And has he pulled out of all his... Because I know he's obviously not on AEW TV, but like I think there's like some indie dates that have been like saying like, yeah, we're not sure yet, but if we will let you refunds, and we're just waiting to hear from Ma. But I don't... I mean, that was over a few days ago, so...
I mean, I'm,
I don't know. Yeah, things have changed.
Trying to find the full gear card. Oh, and also get well soon, Housen, to my boy Dan Housen, who has an unfortunate broken leg. They had surgery for.
He's already made. He's got a GoFundMe. He's already made a few thousand dollars.
Yeah. Cody donated $1,000 to it, and a few others.
Yeah, I saw fucking Twitter Fingers Cardona also sent him something. So. You know, kudos to you, bitch. Cardona. That is very nice to donate.
I mean,
can't knock, yeah. Can't knock you for that.
Sorry.
No, come on.
Had a thing in my throat. Come I'm so on. Sorry.
Because you know he's listening to this.
Cave.
Yes. Let's do predictions.
Predictions.
Okay. I'm pulling up the full gear card real quick.
Well, I got it right here. Or do you want to? Do you want to man the? Do you have a list? Or I could write it down. Or do you want to write it down? Or
I'll man it. All right. Let me find.
Have at it. Have at it. I'm going to drink my coffee.
Okay. Let's do it. Full gear predictions. I guess we'll just go. We'll start
with Brian. Are we making something here? Are we writing something down here? What's going on?
Yeah. Well, Brian, I'll make a nice little graphic.
Yeah, We'll start, I guess, from my perspective, right to left.
Okay.
If that's okay. What it is. So we'll start with Brian and move on. So
your left is my right, Kyle.
Hey, fuck you. Okay. Listen. First match. This is just from what's been announced so far. I don't know. We haven't had a buy-in match announced or anything. I'm sure we'll get that Wednesday, but this is just what we have so far, which is 8 matches. Yeah,
something like that.
So I'm sure there's definitely gonna be more. Indianapolis Street Fight, Inner Circle versus the Man of the Year and American Top Team. First of all, are you excited about that match?
Oh hell no.
I think it could be
don't
fun.
Don't say it.
I think it could be fun, but like I'm so tired of Inner Circle 5-on-5s having to be a street fight or a cinematic match.
No, I'm with you on that. I think having Dan Lambert in there is going to be.
Sucks.
I think it's going to be kind of funny though.
I feel like that's the reason that they're doing the street fight to protect Dan Lambert to make him look.
Yeah, but also they're like probably MMA people. Like they're not really like wrestlers. Yeah.
Okay, I'm just gonna put this little side note. There is a lot of discord that's going on between them.
You goddamn liar.
Who? What are you talking about?
American Top Team. A lot of people. There's supposed to be some people that were in that group that are not in that group because they left and went to another camp because they're like, dude, I can't. It's a bad camp.
Like who?
Just Colby Covington.
Oh, fuck him though.
Oh, fuck him. He was the one who, like, after he lost, he on Twitter, he said that he would probably go to WWE. You wouldn't see him in a second tier promotion like AEW.
He said that because of
yeah.
I'm talking about before.
There's pictures of him in Impact.
No offense, Impact.
But. Yeah,
that's
no
funny. Hey, at least he name dropped AEW and UFC. All right,
so predictions.
But anyway, Brian.
Predictions.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm gonna have to say I'm gonna go Man of the Year because what the fuck? They need to have some kind of win. Like,
put me down there for that too because it's the perfect opportunity to put over Ethan Page and Scorpio Sky.
And I'm gonna go with Inner. I'm just kidding. Man of the Year. It has to be Man of the Year. If they fucking lose the Inner Circle again, why?
Right.
Why?
What are we doing here?
They need to do something with this shit because ratings are going down. So.
Okay. Second match. Super Click versus Jungle Boy Luchasaurus and Christian Cage.
Fucking you know, hate this match
Christian
so
Cage.
Fucking much.
You know, and Super Click has Adam Cole, who no sold a concerto and was on Rampage literally.
Well, like, he didn't no sell it, sold but.
But.
Yeah, my head's pretty confused. But, as I was twitching.
You can't have a match after getting one
point.
Of those immediately
that's
after.
That's a good point. Got to be out like a week or so.
Tony's got to learn, man. Got to let him learn, man.
But anyway,
This one, Super Click. I feel like it's... Yeah, Super I feel Click? Like that's like a no-brainer. They're too hot to take a loss.
Young Bucks without the titles, they got to win a big pay-per-view match, you know?
So Super Click, I'm also going with Super Click.
Okay.
So Super Click all
dumb
around.
Dumb match to begin with, by the way. Could have easily split that up into 2 matches. That would be good.
Yeah.
But
whatever. Yeah, true.
Whatever.
All right. So this one, I don't know. This one could go either way, but I think it's going to go the way I think it's going to go. We got MJF and Darby Allin.
Mm.
just because there's been hints dropped by MJF that he's going to go after the winner of Kenny and Hangman. And
Kenny and Hangman.
I don't know if I've told y'all or not, but I have a very bold prediction. I think AEW is wanting to do like some big shocking thing on the debut of TBS and Dynamite. I think they'll have MJF beat Hangman for the title. Whoa. On that. Yeah.
Huh. Yeah, but this isn't for like any kind of, this isn't a like number one contenders match or anything, right?
This is a rivalry, match.
Yeah. Two pillars, if you will. This is a tough one. I'm gonna say Darby.
Before you say it.
You're gonna say Darby?
Before you say it.
What about you?
It is kind of weird how they're dropping these Wardlow hints in this rivalry.
That's
kind of
why I'm thinking Darby. True. I feel like maybe they pull the trigger.
Oh, you think they pull the trigger on Wardlow?
Yeah, I don't know if it's necessarily him turning on MJF,
I think it'll be him turning on MJF. Maybe like MJF does.
That's what I was gonna say. Yeah,
or wants him to do something. And then he like walks
MJF
out,
instigates
it.
Right.
Yeah. Or maybe Wardlow fucks up again, and then following Dynamite.
Maybe MJF gives him shit throughout the night. Well, we get to the match, something happens.
Right.
Ref gets knocked out. MJF calls for the ring. Wardlow decides on, he just drops the ring and doesn't give it to MJF and walks out.
Okay, so since we're saying all this, I'm still going to go MJF.
You're still saying MJF?
You're going MJF?
Dude.
Where the fuck was Wardlow?
There's a time and place. Where the fuck was Wardlow? God damn it! And the referee's
honestly,
just like, what? Yeah.
I don't know. He better watch out. Dan Housen will tweet if Aubrey is the ref. Dan Housen will tell Aubrey about that. He told Aubrey to keep her phone
while you're reffing
on her.
Wouldn't that be awesome if
he'll Twitter message her? If
Dan Housen was in AEW and every cheating person just like, now!
It would be hysterical if like Aubrey during, I don't know, like say on like a Dark or Elevation match just takes her phone out like in the middle of the ring.
Yeah, she looks and she grabs a mic. She goes, my buddy Dan Housen just texted me and told me that you were cheating.
You cheated.
He saw it on TV.
Just have him be like an enforcer, dude. That'd be a good gimmick. To be an enforcer.
I think AEW is going
to
sign.
You think so?
They have to.
A lot of people are kind of hitting at it, and Cody seems to be a big fan of his. So, I think so.
Not many more watchers.
But anyway,
they have.
I'm going to go. Man, this is so hard, honestly. But I'm going to go with MJF just because I don't really see why Darby would win.
True.
He doesn't have to win.
No. I feel like his win would only do things for MJF and Wardlow.
If Darby wins, like where does he go
from
there?
Exactly.
He's not going to win the championship anytime soon.
That's a good point. I don't know.
But I do want to see Wardlow stuff because I do think they need to pull
I think they'll at least
Wardlow,
tease it. I think we'll get a little
MJF,
bit more of that, if anything.
All right, next match. I never thought in a fucking million years when he signed to AEW that this would be happening within
CM Punk. I'm picking CM Punk.
I wasn't even on that match.
I'm picking
Jackass. I was on Brian and Miro. I'm just kidding.
Shut up. I'm about to say what?
Eddie Kingston and CM Punk. Holy goddamn. I'm
CM
so
Punk.
Stoked for this.
Yeah, I don't think.
It's clearly it's Punk, right?
A lot of people don't like this. A lot of people don't like this.
I think it's going to be good.
Because they're like, oh, I thought you were supposed to put over people, CM Punk.
Yeah, but
they're just fighting these old guys.
Kingston's not a young up and comer.
It's his first match against someone who's not up and coming.
True, right.
Yeah. I mean, how many...
How many
up and coming stars does he have to face before he's allowed to face, like, a dream
right.
match?
This is what he said. This is what CM Punk said. What are you talking about?
Yeah, but
He said, I'm here to put people... That's what he said, Kyle.
He's settling the beef, though. Eddie started the shit, and now he's...
By the way... Not, I'm just going to put this type of note. It was a lackluster way to start it.
It was very... I would have rather them built up more promos, but I think we'll get more on Dynamite, and it'll be great.
To your party.
Yeah, I mean, we still have Dynamite. We still have... We still have... fucking...
So...
Rampage.
Page Ramp.
Next, we have the finals of the World Title Eliminator Tournament, Bryan Danielson and Miro. This one's a little hard for me.
Danielson. Yeah. Come on, guys. Think about it.
You're saying Danielson.
It's It's the reason why they have Miro in here. They have to put a someone that could credibly replace John.
Miro is taking Mox's spot, so
yeah. But Miro,
unless they change the finish, this is still
promo, Kyle?
Supposed to be the Mox and Bryan match.
I was about to say, but did you not hear Miro's promo? Kyle?
Yeah, he was talking about God.
He's talking about how he's gonna beat God's ass.
No, this is what he said. They placed me in this tournament. Until then, Sammy, I'll come back. That's pretty much just told me that, hey, you're going to lose.
Go after Sammy?
You're going to lose because...
So wait,
You're still talking about Sammy in the same promo that you're inserting.
Maybe God will interfere.
That's true.
In this match.
Well, God didn't help Shawn Michaels.
Maybe... Yeah, that's another thing. That's another thing I've been wanting to ask people. Do we know if God is still contracted to WWE or... like?
I think he's gone after that Katie Vick scenario. Yeah.
Okay, so who's everybody saying? Who you got, Brian?
I'm gonna
Does Brian have Miro?
I'm gonna say Miro, and
you're going Miro. Wow.
I'm gonna say a certain someone debuts and helps him win.
I got Danny Bry.
Who
his
debuts?
This motherfucker. I think that his wife would debut when he's doing the championship thing with Sammy, since it's such a...
Yeah, but this could be the thing that actually helps him get over the hump, finally.
Okay, well, if she speaks Russian, I'm fucking
also,
out.
Also, he's doing all this, like, Jesus and God stuff, and meanwhile, she's very, like...
I bring the belt back to my wife.
Yeah, like, I don't know, she's a very sexual character. Well, at least in WWE she was, I don't know what her...
About to say, come on, man.
Yeah.
Who you got, MJ?
I got Danny Bryan.
Who do
you got?
I'm also going with Bryan Danielson.
I think you said you were going with
Bryan. I got Bryan Danielson.
Like me, Bryan.
Yeah, I got Bryan Danielson. Okay, and a very anticipated match, and well, for me, the AEW Women's World Championship, who has the best butt, Tay Conti or Britt Baker?
Their words, not ours.
Their words, not ours.
She doesn't have that much of a hump, you know?
But, if we're going by that, I mean, it's clear as day who wins that contest. But, anyway, obviously, come on. Yeah. This is a no-fucking-brainer. Tay Conti, no, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I think we're all in agreement.
Britt Baker. I mean, she's only going to drop that belt to Thunder Rosa.
They definitely could have picked someone else to face Britt.
They definitely could have, but I like it. It gives talk. I feel she deserves a main event, like a title picture on a pay per view.
I agree.
The match that has. Well, not necessarily this match, but more of all, this moment has been built up since the beginning of AEW. A match we've been waiting for over a year for. AEW World Championship, Kenny Omega versus Hangman Page.
We're missing the tag.
Yeah,
there's a few matches, actually. It's a few matches. I don't want to do that one yet.
No, we could do it. Yeah, we could do it.
Oh, wait. Tag
team. AEW Tag Team Championships? What is your problem?
My bad, X. Okay. I missed one match because that's all I've got on the card. One other match. The AEW World Tag Team AEW Tag Team Championships, not the AAA Tag Team Championships. Lucha Bros versus FTR.
Lucha Bros cannot lose.
Yeah, they're not losing because they just
got the fucking titles.
And aren't they going to Mexico, or did they already go? I know it was either last week or this week.
I have not seen anything on that yet.
No, they're going with Vicky.
Yeah.
You didn't see that, MJ?
I haven't seen it.
Oh, you're talking about FTR.
Yeah, I'm talking about FTR, sorry.
Yeah, I forgot which one. I forgot which days.
I haven't seen it.
They are going to AAA 5 days ago, so I think it was this weekend?
Okay.
That makes sense, because you got to get that out of the way before you go.
I mean, if they drop the AAA titles, then...
I don't think they'll do that either, because they just got the motherfuckers.
Right.
It's true.
Lucha Bros just got the motherfuckers, so...
That's true. I'm going FTR. Which I'm going FTR. Yeah.
MJ?
Fuck Brian?
Oh, wait, no, this is for the AEW Tag Team Championships.
Yes!
Yeah, dude!
I know, it just registered. No.
They just got
Lucha Brothers. Lucha Brothers.
Lucha Brothers? Yeah. Okay, MJ? Lucha Bros?
Young Bucks. somehow they're going to come in, just like Moose did, with Josh Alexander and Tatum.
No, no. Lucha Bros. Hey. I'm also going Lucha Bros. All right, now, main event, World Championship, Kenny Omega, Hangman Page. We've been waiting fucking over a year for this. This moment's been...
Whoa, I thought Andrade had a match.
He does.
No.
He does. It's a tag match.
Yeah, it's a tag
match. It's not on this card.
Yeah, you're right. I knew it. Him and Pac versus not on this
card. Cody and Pac versus Malachi.
Has that been made official?
Yeah, they announced it.
According to Bleacher Report...
They haven't announced it.
It is...
There's not a
graphic?
Or is it on Rampage?
A match card.
You sure?
Yeah.
Is it on Rampage?
Yeah. There's no match card for it yet.
Or is it on Dynamite? All right.
There's no match graphic for it yet, but let's go ahead and just throw it in there. I'm sure it'll get announced Wednesday. Cody and Pac versus Malachi and Andrade? Mm-hmm. Very interesting.
Definitely weird.
Tactic. Also,
take a swig of my milk on that one.
You drinking milk? chocolate milk. I mean, just
also,
like
there's an elephant. There's an elephant in the room here.
Where?
There's an impending debut that possibly could happen at this pay per view. But I wonder where he would come out at.
Oh,
he tweeted out things about Rome. Who's been saying stuff about Rome?
Is that Cody?
Malachi.
Cody?
Newell said so.
Who else has been talking about Rome? Jake the Snake. Who has Rome
been indicated at?
Cody. Who is Malachi's Rome stuff talked about? Cody.
So who do you think? You think it's going to be like...
He basically... Malachi's promo on Dynamite was basically kind of indicating that... He basically said that Brutus wasn't the only person who betrayed Caesar. Okay. So indicating there's a betrayal.
I think Arn's gonna turn on Cody.
That's what my thing is. I think Arn's gonna turn on Cody.
And then we're gonna see Jake the Snake come out and say, "I fucking told you."
But we have the impending debut of possibly Wyndham Rotunda. Where would you think he would show?
I mean, that makes sense right here, right? If he was gonna happen, it would happen in this match.
Honestly. The best way to debut him would be on TBS.
I don't think that they'd hold off that long. That's not until January.
What? But that's not the what the point is, dude. That's what you're supposed to do, man. As a booker, as you do these shows, you're supposed to hold off on this so late at later.
Nah, he's already like been teasing it. Like it's happening soon. Like,
okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and pick fucking Hangman.
You're gonna pick Hangman?
Yeah, I'm picking Hangman also.
I'm also going to go with Kenny. I'm hanging at Hangman Page.
Ooh, all right.
100%. No, you know what? No. What? That's the main 100%. Event. We all can't agree on the main event.
Sorry. No,
yes, we can.
That's the way it is.
No, we can't. Nope.
Wait, main event, actually, breaking news. This isn't breaking, but according to BleacherReport.com, there is the buy-in match was announced. It was... Where did it go?
Does that have something to do with Dante Martin?
I bet Serena Deeb versus Hikaru Shida.
Again?
Whoa. Wait a minute. Bleach Report's fucking wrong. There's no way Tony's
this is
insane.
The third time.
Yeah, but in 4 weeks, that means that there was only 1 week where they didn't face it. You know what I'm saying? Stupid.
Oh, okay, maybe it's not announced yet.
Okay, maybe it's not announced
yet.
But if it is, stupid.
Yeah, I don't think I would be into that, but... All right, so there are...
I just got done watching.
Dude. Did y'all... Okay, on Rampage, I don't think it was this... Was it this... this past week's Rampage, there's something I want to mention. Did y'all hear Max Caster's rap on Brian Danielson?
Yes.
Holy fucking shit. The line he said where he said, "I'm going to put you in poverty, dog, because I end careers quicker than your father-in-law." I lost it, because for those who aren't aware... Brian's father-in-law is John Laurinaitis.
Vince, you have very vascular arms.
Who is behind, you know, all the recent WWE releases.
Wait a minute.
You didn't know that, MJ?
You didn't know that?
That's the Bella's dad?
Father-in-law. The Bella's...
Father-in-law.
Mom is married to him.
To John Laurinaitis.
Oh. See, I was confused. I'm like, there's no way that's their real
dad. No, you're not real dad. No. Just through marriage. He's their stepdad, I guess.
He said that.
I don't think
Max Caster, man, you know, besides that one where he went a little too far, man, he never
missed. No, this was that was the perfect one.
Well, dude, I never even knew that. That put this shit in whole new
Well, there you go. That's why you learn something on AEH, even as we...
Not from you guys. I learned it by
myself.
Well, true,
myself. Yeah, true.
But yeah, that's...
so that's...
I think that's everything.
That's the Full Gear predictions. Those are our predictions. I'll make a nice little graphic and put that out on our Twitter.
That's the show. See y'all next week.
Yeah, we have to go. We are on a tight budget time constraint. Go join the AEW All Elite Wrestling Discussion Facebook group. Go listen to Marked Out Wrestling Podcast. Subscribe, like,
I got brunch with Malenko.
Who?
I got brunch with Malenko.
Dean Malenko?
Wow.
All right. Tell him we said hi. And I don't know. We'll probably do something for Full Gear. I don't know. Maybe like a quick post show or something, or if we're all around or something.
So.
We'll figure it out. But look for our predictions. Hopefully we'll find out our password on Twitter. That's our big to do this week.
Ah!
So hopefully we'll get that going. MJ, I think that's some MJ. I know MJ's on the case. What? Did you get it?
This has nothing to do with AEW. Oh. This has nothing to do with AEW, but they just announced Ishii versus Jay White on the same card that Buddy Matthews is facing Kazuchika
Okada.
That's
fucking cool.
So,
all right.
Have y'all heard the rumors behind that? Apparently, Kenta called out CM Punk after he won the U.S. Championship.
Ooh.
And people think that AEW and New Japan is going to do it in exchange where Kenta and CM Punk happens in Japan in exchange for Okada and Bryan and AEW.
Stop it.
Shit, when are we going to see Kenny in New Japan?
That's not happening.
Can you imagine Okada and Bryan in AEW?
Oh.
They already had Jay go face-to-face with Kenny. So
thank you guys for listening.
Anyway, yeah.
We'll be back next week.
I got to get a shower.
You can do it. Go and do it.
Well, we're doing plugs.
I mean, we have to go. Oh. We're already a minute over. I told Kyle we were going to be done by.
Join the AEW All Your Wrestling Discussion group. MJ's got pages.
House of Black.
House of Black content coming soon. And listen to Marked Out Wrestling podcast.
Right. MJ, do you have any plugs?
And have a great day.
Have a fantastic day.
Make sure you catch Thanksgiving Day. GSW Thanksgiving Day.
Oh yeah, that's in a few weeks.
In a few weeks. So
three
watch out for
title
that.
Matches.
Masha Slamovich versus Jordan Blade, man.
Robert Martyr versus Gio Galvano.
There will not be any Hammerstone because he's still...
Wait, what's the third one? We're missing one. I don't know. Kyle's got to go. Thank you, guys. We'll see you next week. Bye.
Give a fuck if Kyle has to...
And good night, Ben!
Catch you on the flip side.
Marked Out Podcast is produced and edited by U-Record Studios and from Charlotte, North Carolina. Subscribe, follow, and listen to us live on YouTube, Twitch, and Facebook Live. Download the podcast by following us at podbean.com or subscribe on iTunes and Apple Podcasts. While you're there, go ahead and give us an honest and fair review and rating. Finally, if you have enjoyed our product and would like to see us grow, please donate to us by visiting the donation link below our live video, or you can donate via Venmo and Cash App at the handle RavePro. That's RavePro.
You're listening to the Electronic Media Collective Podcast Network. Yeah, it's a mouthful. For more great shows, visit electronicmediacollective.com.